Hello, and welcome back to Third Eye Thursdays, and welcome to part two of the little video series on crystals to use to open third eye, right? So in today's video, again, we do have three more crystals that you can use to start working with to open the third eye. So the first one I have here today is Chevron Amethyst. So let me move it actually to the other side so you can see it. So this was a stone I've had this since I was a teenager, and this was actually one of the first stones I started working with many years ago, but like right before I started on the awakening path. I started getting into lucid dreaming and astral travel and all that stuff, and I came across Chevron Amethyst. Was a really good stone to use as a protector if you want to go astral travel. So as I was trying to project, you know, myself into the astral realm at night, and I would do lucid dreamings, and I would try to astral travel. I would have two of them, actually don't have it with me, but I put one in each hand as I would fall asleep, and I would also listen to binaural beats, and I could go on that another video, how to astral travel, however. So I would use these as my protectors, right? So the third eye does connect us to the other realms, the other dimensions, right? It is our psychic intuition and all that stuff, but like, how do we connect to the spiritual world? It's through our third eye. So if I want to go astral travel, I definitely am working with the third eye chakra, right? So this was a good stone that I found, and I was like, oh, I got two of them. So I just started using them again at night to go astral travel, right? So again, this is a third eye stone. You can put it on your third eye to meditate. If you do want to try astral travel, this is a great stone to work with, right? This will definitely help open your third eye and connect you to the other realms, okay? All right, so the second stone I have today is rhodonite. Okay, now rhodonite's very interesting because when I first got it, I connected with the heart chakra a lot more, and it was healing, and I used it a lot with my heart chakra. However, the more I used it, the more it was like this slow awakening, slow activation. It was like slowly opening up my third eye. And so I do feel it is a third eye awakening and activator. So I would definitely like to incorporate this, the rhodonite. With this one, I just got a little like tumbled stone. I got it at a local metaphysical store. You can get any kind, whether they're tumbled or raw or clustered or whatever it is. And I just kind of carried it on me for a little bit, but this one I felt like I was surprised with. I was like, wow, I didn't think you were a third eye stone, and it was. So this is a good one to also to incorporate. And the third one I have, gosh, I feel like I always say the name wrong. It's like Lepidolite. I'll put it in the video. Lepidolite. So this one, obviously, because of its color, will resonate with the third eye. Anything purple will. The third eye is a deep indigo, but purple definitely is a color that resonates as the third eye chakra. So this one is, it feels like when I use it, it connects me to like journeys, okay? It connects me to like ancient wisdoms and traveler energy, okay? I don't know, that's just what I feel when I use it. It does help spark new levels of awakening when I'm ready for a transition, right? We're all going through the spiritual awakening path, so there's ups and downs. And when I'm at that transitional point, it sparks a new level in my awakening. Maybe I get another level of my third eye chakra opening, but I like level up with it. That's why it's like this traveler stone, because I have it as I go up and down in the spiritual journey. So this is a really good one to have for your third eye, because it just assists you on your spiritual awakening path, allowing you to tap into that other world, that other dimension of the spiritual side of you, right? Which is your third eye does connect there, and the purple definitely does resonate with it. So that's another really good stone to have to incorporate with your third eyes. And we'll wrap up today's video right there, and we'll see you again next week. So if you guys got anything out of this video, do me a favor and hit that thumbs up button. This way I know you got something that resonated. If you guys haven't already subscribed to my channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button, and there's a bell too. You want to hit the bell and turn on all notifications, because I do daily videos and I don't want you guys to miss out on any upcoming messages. That next message just might be the message that you need to hear today. All right, my loves, till next time, be blessed.